Hello. Due to some technical difficulties, we have to stop at the end of question number 13. Okay. Now, in this video, we'll start from the question number 14. Okay. Of GATE of 2018, of production and industrial unit. Okay. So, the question number 14 is. Which one of the following process is not used for producing powder? So answer is your sintering. Okay. So the automation, ball milling, and electrolysis, all the three processes are used for producing powder. Whereas sintering is used to press the powder or compact the powder and forming a solid and forms a solid mass by the use of heat or pressure. Okay, so sintering is not a powder producing. Sintering is not a powder producing process. Okay, next, the question number 15. The process in which the molten plastic is forced between the rolls to produce thin sheets is. The answer is calendaring. The blow molding, extrusion, and compression molding are not used for producing sheets in thermoplastic. Whereas the calendaring is used to produce thermoplastic. Thermoplastic sheets when a bolt of thermoplastic is passed between the rollers. Okay, so reading out the explanation, the blow molding is a specific manufacturing process by which hollow plastic parts are formed and can be joined to it. Okay, second, the compression molding is the process of molding in which a preheated polymer is placed into an open heated mold cavity. The mold is then closed with a through plug and with a hot plug and compressed in order to have material contact all the area of the mold. Okay. And third, the calendaring is the process in which the molten plastic, thermoplastic, is forced between rolls to produce thin sheet. Fourth, the extrusion is the process of producing thick closed section profile by the use of knife. Okay. Next. Next question is question number 16. The diagonal element of a 3 by 3 matrix are minus 10, 5, and 0 respectively. If two of its eigenvalues are minus 15 each, the third eigenvalue is. So we know that the sum of eigenvalues is equal to sum of diagonal elements. Okay. And here the two of the eigenvalues are minus 15, minus 15. So, and third is for lambda 3. And, sum of diagonal is minus 5 plus 5 is 0. So lambda 3 is your 25. So answer is your 25. Okay. Next. Question number 17. The weights in kg of 6 products are 3, 7, 6, 2, 3, and 4. The median weight bracket in kg up to 1 decimal place is. So this is. Arranging this in increasing order or ascending order, okay, to find out variance. Okay, so this is the ascending order 2, 3, 3, 4, 6, 7. Okay, as there are total 6 products, okay, so the median will be the n by second or n by second plus 1. Okay, this n is your 6, so it is third or and fourth average. Okay, so third is your 3 and fourth is your 4, so median is your 7 by 2, that is 3.5. Okay, next, the probabilities of occurrence of events F and G are PF is equal to 0.3 and PG is equal to 0.4 respectively. The probability that both events occur simultaneously is P bracket F intersection G is equal to 0.2. The probability of occurrence of at least one event P bracket F intersection F union G is, we know that the union and intersection relationship is P F U G is equal to P G plus P F plus P minus, sorry, minus P F intersection G. Okay, so all the values are given. So PG is your 0.4 and P F is your 0.3 and P F intersection G is your 0.2, so answer is your 0.4. Okay. Next, a flywheel in the form of a solid circular disc of radius 100 mm and uniform thickness has a mass of 10 kg. If it is rotating at uniform angular velocity of 20 radians per second, the kinetic energy in joule of the flywheel is, so here mass of the flywheel is 10 kg, okay, and the radius of the flywheel is 100 mm, okay, and we know as the flywheel is of solid circular disk type, okay, so its radius of rotation is r by root 2, okay, and moment of inertia is your mk square plus mr square by 2, okay, and kinetic energy is nothing but half I omega square, and omega is your mean speed is your 20 radians per second. So putting this value, we will have I 1 by 2, m r square by 2, omega square, okay, m is your 10, r is your, radius is your 100 by 1000 meter, okay, putting this value we can get kinetic energy as 10 joule, okay. Next, a cylindrical wooden block of length 50 centimeter is floating in water in such a way that its axis is vertical. The density of the densities of wood and water are 800 kilogram per meter cube and 1000 kilogram per meter cube respectively. The submerged depth, that is depth of immersion in centimeter of the cylinder is, so here the cross section area of the wooden cylindrical block is not given, so let it be A, okay, and height of the or length of the cylindrical block is just 50 centimeters, so what is it, 0.5 meters, okay. Now density of the wood is 800 kilogram per meter cube, so weight of the wooden block is just 800 rho g into volume, so rho it is, this is rho, this is g, this is volume, okay, so this is the weight of the wooden block, okay. Now when it is in vertical position in water, so let h, small h, be the depth or the height up to which the wooden block is immersed in water, okay, what is depth of immersion, okay, so then the volume inside the water is your a into h, okay, and this is the water displaced also, okay, so volume of block in water is equal to volume of water displaced, so that is ah, okay. Now weight of the block is your this, okay, and this is, this will be the weight of water, this of the buoyant force, okay, so this is your 400 ag, okay. Now volume of water displaced is providing buoyant force, okay, or so the this is the volume of the water displaced, okay, volume of the water displaced, and weight of water displaced is if you multiply it by density into g, okay, so this is the weight of water displaced, okay. So now for balance, the weight of the wooden block should be equal to weight of water displaced, and weight of wooden block is your weight of wooden block is your this quantity, okay, and weight of water displaced is your this quantity, okay. So now equating 1 and 3, you can get h as 0.4 meter or 40 centimeter, okay. Next, a machine consists of three components P, Q, and R connected serially. The reliability of P, Q, and R are 0.97, 0.86, and 0.93 respectively. To increase the reliability of the machine, two additional stand by units of Q are added. Okay, the overall reliability up to 2 decimal places of the machine is, so here the reliability of P is just 0.97 and Q is just 0.86 and point R is of 0.83. okay, now two additional Q units are also attached okay, so the overall the overall picture becomes like that, okay, so this is your there are 3 Q, 1 P, and R, okay, so these are in parallel, okay. So the and these three RM series, so availability of machine is just RP into reliability of the three into RP. Okay. So the reliability of this Q is your 0.97, okay. And for the three part, it will be one minus reliability of reliability of Q, one minus reliability of Q. So this will be the formula for finding out reliability in parallel. Okay. So the reliability of Q is just 0.97, and now P is 0.97, and reliability part is 0.96. So overall reliability is product of this answer here 0.8993. Okay. Next, the mean time between failure of a machine is 400 hours. If the availability of the machine is 80%, the mean time to repair in hours is, so the availability is just 80%. The total mean time is just 400 hours. Okay. And total availability is just 400 into 0.8, because availability is just 80%. Okay. So, and total mean time is just 400, availability will be 320 hours. So, rest of the time it will be the repairing time. Okay. So, the total mean time to repair is just total mean time divided by, minus total availability. Okay. So, that is 80 hours. Okay. Next, answer is 80 hours. Next, the processing time on a single machine for three jobs are given below. All the jobs are available for time t is equal to 0. Okay. For time t is equal to 0. So job 1 to 3 and processing time is 15, 3 and 6. The mean flow time in minute as per the shortest processing time SPT is equal to 0. So you have to arrange these jobs according to shortest processing time. So the minimum processing time is for job 2. So we will take the job 2 first, because this processing time is zero and its completion at is starting from 0. Okay, so it will be completed by after 3 minutes. Okay, and the second minimum is your that 3. So we will take the 3. Okay, then that job will be completed after 9 minutes, because for the first job the completion time is completion time is 3, so it will start after 3 minutes, so it will complete after 9 minutes. Okay, and last job is your 15, your this is having maximum time is job 1, that is the processing time for this job is your 15, so and the completion time will be your 15 plus 9 is equal to 24, so the total time is your 36. Okay, 3 9. Okay, 36. So average flow time is just 36 by 3. So that is 12. Answer is just 10. Okay. So this is the average flow time. Sorry, total flow time. Average flow time is 12. Next, in a two-pass wire drying process, there is in a two-pass wire drying process, there is 40% reduction in wire cross-section area in first pass and 30% reduction in second pass. The overall reduction in percentage is dash